not in panic mode yet. This is still sleeping, but I have no idea where I am. But I'm sure someone will find me, or I will find someone soon enough. If not, I love you, Marisa.
Welcome back to No Tears, Frontiers Diaries. As you can tell, today we're in a little bit of a different place. We are in a hotel room that was much needed, and hopefully this episode will help you understand why we needed this hotel room so badly. Because we had a wonderful evening in Joshua Tree. Mm-hmm. We were walking around.
Wonderful evening sunset. Is very loose.
Well, no. The evening was good.
I remember this. From 5 years ago when we were here last time, and it was just so beautiful, just as beautiful as it is now, just so peaceful. There's something that feels really special about this place.
Yeah, the sunset was nice, and we did a little walk around that we were reminiscing of days of past. We dug in and crawled around some of the boulders, and it was fun.
And when you go into that boulder landscape, I get lost very easily. It feels like it's leading you through this maze, and I feel like I'm so far away from the campsite. But then we kind of climbed up on this ridge, and I realized the campsite was no more than 50 yards away.
Yeah.
But it had led us down this labyrinth of paths around the boulders.
If there wasn't a guy with a big old tent camped next to us, I would have not known that's where our campsite
was. Yeah, that's true.
It was very crazy.
This apparently is our track, which is kind of cool. You know, there's like a big old Gonzo or something from Sesame Street.
Some of our neighbors, three dudes popped out from Cali, and they were really cool, and they said that there was like a meteor shower that night, so we were really, really excited. But we had just had a long day, so I definitely needed a nap, and especially after our little hike. But we were super excited to wake up, take some night photography. Clouds are really not an issue in Joshua National Park, so...
Exactly. We knew we were going to be in a good spot for this night photography.
Yeah.
So we set our alarms, but we didn't even need our alarm.
No, we had Chatty Cathy's.
Good morning. We have woken up at Joshua Tree.
Good morning. Good morning. Did you?
It is very beautiful here. We saw some of the meteor shower last night, which was nice. But we had some neighbors that kept us up until 2 or 3 in the morning. So that wasn't my favorite thing at a campground, but eventually they left. They were about like 10 feet away from us. Like, here's our campsite. And it wasn't even a campsite. They were just right there. But we were up anyway, huh?
Be like State Farm and be a good neighbor.
Be a good neighbor, that's right. All you campers out there, be a good neighbor. But we were watching the meteor shower anyway. They weren't even neighbors.
They weren't even camping there. And this isn't a long drawn out story of poo-poo, but there was seven or eight gaggling geese that were just honking all night.
They were very loud about it, and it kept us up. So we woke up anyway to see the meteors, and they were very cool. But I do think those neighbors kind of ruined the mood. And they were chatting there until 2 in the morning.
And then they had their car with their high beams on just beaming right into our tent. And I was trying to be as nice as I possibly could until that moment. And then I walked out and I said, you guys got to be kidding me. This is getting ridiculous.
But, it's too much.
So be good people out there, folks. When you're, you know.
It definitely ruined the peacefulness of Joshua Tree for us that night. And the other problem was we got very little sleep. But so we woke up a bit tired.
Yes.
We are headed to the coast, but we don't know how to traverse Los Angeles. It's, we don't really want to go through the middle of Los Angeles because of all the traffic. So we're going to try our best to go around Los Angeles. There seems to be lots of beautiful mountains and parks around it. So we're going to try our best to go through that without having a terribly long day. But our end result, hopefully, is to get to a campground right on the Pacific Ocean. That's our goal for today. So let's see if we can do it.
Yeah, and we kind of exited the park in a different way. Last time we were in Joshua Tree, we did a pretty north to south entrance and exit. This time we broke west a little bit and northwest and just went a different way. And man, am I so glad we did. As we exited the park through the west, it was, you know, a side of the park that we've never seen before, and I do have to think that the west side is the best side.
This is freaking. Yeah, I don't think we ever went out this way.
There were so many Joshua trees and the boulders. I don't know what it is about those beautiful windswept boulders and Joshua trees, like right next to each other, but they seem to be symbiotic because there's just tons and tons of Joshua trees and very cool rock formations all together. It was a very unexpected and cool ride.
Yeah, no, it was amazing.
That whole ride over through Southern California was very beautiful. It kept changing. Strange place for lunch, or at least it had some interesting decor.
Oh yeah.
Where's that guy?
good patty
burrito.
Melt,
yeah. And it's always nice to have a good rest stop, especially something that's unique. It's hard to find places off the franchise trail when it comes to the United States. So.
I'll tell you, we stopped at Subway the other day, and it was like $28 for two sandwiches.
Yeah, so here's the other rude awakening, is coming into California. California is expensive.
Yep.
And all across the country, it's been expensive as of late, especially gas prices. But California was just a little bit of sticker shock for us.
It was a giant sticker. It was a really giant sticker.
But is it worth it? Well, of course. We've been having such a great time.
Oh, for sure.
We headed around Los Angeles, through the hills, and made our way west all the way to the Pacific Ocean.
What ocean specifically?
It is the Pacific Ocean.
It is. It's very specific. It's the one on the left side of the map when you're looking at the United States.
Ooh, big waves. The romantic view of the ocean in between RVs.
I had really wanted to camp at this one place called Refugio State Park. Yeah. And we got there, and this was another thing that we're going to have to start learning more, is you need to have online reservations before you get there.
The
it seems to be a
just
theme.
Roaming around, you know, meandering and stumbling across campsites and staying wherever we want is maybe of the days in the past.
But we were surprised when we got there, and you found a place on iOverlander that was further up the coast a little bit. And you say, hey, let's check that out. Since we don't have a reservation for this one, let's go up and check out this place.
Yeah.
But I am so thankful that we took this little journey to the other campground.
Yeah.
Because the road there, like you get on Highway 1 and then you get off of Highway 1 on this kind of just backcountry road.
Crazy trees. I'm not even going to try to say eucalyptus. I said it.
You said it. Eucalyptus trees. And then there were some that looked like the milkwood trees in South Africa.
From the Wild Coast.
Oh, it was beautiful. And then you hit the ocean. And it was coming down this cliffside.
Zigs and zags and then re-zig and then re-zag.
And you're just confronted with this mighty blue sea. Really, really beautiful.
And then there was like these cliffs way in the distance as we're, you know, going down towards the campsite. It was really, really cool. And their campsite sign said full too, and I was like, no! But the guy, I was like, can you sneak us in anywhere? It's like, oh yeah, sure, for sure. And he gave us a pretty nice campsite.
Yes, and you could hear the waves of the ocean. The ocean was just pounding the beach. So we've arrived at a campground that's on the beach. You can kind of hear it in the background. can't see it from here though. But another nice surprise is Tim is blowing up the sleeping pads. That's usually my job, but he's doing it for me.
I can do things too.
So that was really nice of him, and we're going to make some dinner and then go to the beach. So I don't know if you noticed, but my hair is pretty gross. It's been a while since I showered.
AKA normal for me. Still a week to go here.
I need to wash my hair, and the shower only takes quarters, and quarters are not something that we normally carry on the bike because they're kind of heavy. So I realized that the water coming out of the dishwashing area was pretty warm. So I just filled up our little MSR bag, and I'm gonna just wash my hair. My little bar of shampoo. I love it. It's great. Wow, it's really warm.
Oh, look at Marisa. Thudhead. Looking like the Joker from the latest Batman. Why so serious?
It's super nice, Tim. You should try this.
Give it a week.
All right.
Good.
I finished.
Yay. I have finished too.
No. We had a lovely dinner looking out over the ocean. Yeah. Today was stunning. It was really, really beautiful, and we're finishing it off with a fantastic view of the Pacific Ocean here in California. But it was also a hard day, and I think it was because we didn't sleep well last night. There were the neighbors at the Joshua Tree campground that kept us up all night long. So I think that contributed to just being a little bit more tired than usual and a little bit more cranky. And then also it was a long day. But besides those two things, it was a beautiful ride. We were able to bypass Los Angeles and bypass all the traffic. We didn't get stuck in any traffic. It was all beautiful views no matter where we went. And we made it to an incredible beach. And so it rounded out a day that was a bit difficult, but overall ended fabulously. So we'll see what tonight is like. So perfect sunset. The sun's going, you can watch it literally just go down. So quickly.
The wildlife was very friendly. They were very aware that humans,
okay,
you know, birds were quite attentive to what we may or may not be doing. You know, there's little creatures that would stick their heads out of the ground.
We're improvising. Hey, birdie. We got some bird friends that are also curious.
We should have taken that as a warning.
Oh, yeah.
No, but we thought, oh, this is great. The animals are super.
It's kind of like, what's that Disney princess?
Oh, Snow White?
Snow White. No, the one that, was that Snow White? Yeah, maybe it was.
Yeah, Snow White. It's
I don't
the
know
one
my
with
Disney
like the birds
princesses.
In her hands. I mean, the birds were just coming right up to us.
Yeah, and I had a conversation with one of it.
You did have a full-on conversation with one. But that night,
We were already super exhausted, not only from the day, but from the night before with the very loud neighbors. And then that night, we became the very loud neighbors because, but for good reason.
Not for good reason.
It was definitely for a good reason.
No, because we did something stupid. That's not a good reason.
Inside the Nemo tent. The California sunset.
We hung the majority of our food up in a tree, and then we left
a bag
of powdery, yummy goodness little
to be fair, it was
stuff.
All dried pasta.
It was all dried pasta.
Like powder packets.
But it had powder packets. This raccoon got in it, and it looked like, you know, Tony Montana. He was just, you know, like...
So we put our tent right under this tree, and apparently that is the home of... One,
so we'd
possibly
steal our
two
food
raccoons.
And then run up the tree. And then I saw him, and I thought he broke into our main orange bag, and I didn't want him chewing a hole through that, so I freaked out.
The tree is also where we hung our main bag of food.
So that we had a full-on war with... There's no weapons involved, but this thing was very... it wasn't even aggressive. It was a very peaceful...
I think the raccoon was aggressive, but he did not, like, bite us or attack us. He was after food. He was not a rabid...
He was
raccoon,
fearless.
But he
wasn't
could have
aggressive.
Been a rabid raccoon in my mind. This is where I started freaking out. Yeah. I was not happy about this raccoon so close to us and being very, very aggressive towards getting food
not aggressive,
from us.
Just fearless. Fearless.
Fearless. That's right. Now, I had previously put a sandwich, two sandwiches, in my backpack. I had also wrapped up some French fries that had been left over and put that in my backpack. All of that food was... out of my backpack. We had eaten it.
Yeah.
But this raccoon, except my apple, but this raccoon wanted my backpack. And it was right next to me in the tent. And I could...
Outside of the tent.
Well, yeah. But it was still right next to me. I mean, it was no more than 3 inches away from me. And I could hear this raccoon going after my backpack. And then when I would look with my flashlight, I could see his paws and then his head like poke up under the rain fly and just grabbing at my backpack. I mean, he wanted to tear it apart.
He was curious.
He was
sniffing.
Really upset, and I started freaking out. And I think freaking out in any situation is bad. It's just the incorrect reaction. There's always a better reaction than freaking out. But I freaked out. I'm like, get away! I mean, I must have woken up the whole campground. Yeah. And finally, you know, I'd scare him off, but he'd come back. And an hour later, and this went on until 3-something in the morning. And all I could think of was, all right, I either need to put my backpack someplace where he can't get it, and where could that be?
We hung the backpack.
We finally had to dig out our paracord and hang the backpack from the tree, which was the same tree that the raccoon was in. I was just in total freak out mode. Yeah. But I was also thinking, I cannot wait for the sun to rise. Like I was being attacked by vampires or something. Like, please let the sun rise and let these creatures stop bothering me.
Don't leave your food out. Hang all your stuff. And that was a rookie move.
It was really bad of us.
And
it was good that we learned our lesson before we were in bear country.
It was just a dumb trip up that we did. And not again. And thank God it wasn't in bear country. But it's almost embarrassing to say that we left a bunch of our food out and didn't know what to do. It's not that we didn't know what to do. We were just had been lazy and missed what happened. But yeah, we were bothered by a raccoon all night.
Yes.
Didn't get very much sleep that night either.
So by the time the sun did rise, we groggily woke up.
Yeah.
And we had this fantastic day ahead of us, but I was seriously doubting whether we should even do it because I was so tired and I knew you were, I mean, you're the rider of the motorcycle. That was two nights in a row.
Two nights of crappy sleep.
Yeah.
You know, and there's a cycle you can get into which sucks of, you know, a bad night's rest equals a bad day's ride, which equates to another bad night's rest. You know, and I don't want to, because that takes a lot of the fun away, you know.
Yeah. So stay tuned for our next episode to see what happens.
See our next wild camping spot.
Now you understand why we're here. And I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give us a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button below.
Ding, ding.
And we'll be seeing you next time.
Peace, everybody.
Bye.
Stay safe. You can see like these, you know, really jagged rock piles, what it seems. They're barest minimum, you know, they're barest floor mats.